Hello wonderful person, this is Anton, and in today's video we're going to be continuing our discussion about the most habitable planets close to us, other than of course Earth, and other than the planets in our solar system. In other words, we're going to discover and explore the exoplanets that we think might have the highest habitability close to planet Earth. Anyway, let's take a look at them in Universe Sandbox, and welcome to What the Math. Now, specifically, what we're going to be doing is looking at the same planets we looked at in one of the previous videos, and we're going to then do it scientifically and take a look at what's known as the Earth Similarity Index, which for some reason Earth in this simulation only has 99.8% of. In other words, this shows you how similar an exoplanet is to Earth. Now, if you were to look at Earth Similarity Index of Venus, for example, it's about 43.5. Mercury is about 63%, and that's because it doesn't have as much heat as Venus does. And Mars has the Earth similarity that is about 64.3. We're going to go out there and look at the exoplanets from a list of nearest exoplanets on Wikipedia and put them in Universe Sandbox and basically discover which one of them is the most habitable. This is actually what you can find on Wikipedia, a list of nearest exoplanets, and the list is actually pretty long. Now we're going to take a look at the ones with the little heart. That's because these are the planets that we think might be habitable. The one on top is Proxima Centauri. And once I place Proxima Centauri, Proxima B appears right here. And if you take a look at this beautiful yet unusual planet, you'll notice that, assuming that it doesn't have any atmosphere because it's orbiting a red dwarf, its Earth similarity is probably somewhere around stunning 90%. Why? Well, it's because it does have relatively similar mass to Earth. It is in the habitable zone of this particular star, yet it's suffering from the unfortunate factor of being around a flare star. Flare stars are very, very active stars that release a lot of radiation, and Proxima Centauri is one of those stars. So this might actually be a little bit of an exaggeration. Nevertheless though, based on Universe Sandbox parameters, this is so far the most Earth-like planet we have. And if I run this relatively long, it will actually stabilize around 95.5%, which is surprisingly high. And this is because the mass of this planet is very close to Earth, its radius is also very close to Earth, its density, although we don't really know exactly what its mass is, to be honest, but its density is probably Earth-like as well. And the highest mass estimates we have for it is about 3 masses of Earth, which would give this planet the Earth similarity of about 90%. So far so good. Let's go to the next one. And the next on the list with a little heart is Tau Ceti E, and this is in a system known as Tau Ceti. So we're going to remove this system and place the Tau Ceti right here along with its planets. Now the one we're looking for is here. This is of course in the habitable zone. So Tau Ceti E, which kind of looks a little bit more metallic here, mostly because it's basically filled with all kinds of water, has the Earth similarity of about 74%. Still much higher than anything in our own solar system. Very, very high, and actually very surprisingly high. But not as high as Proxima Centauri. Alright, let's go to the next one. The Captain Star. And this here is also very Earth-like, a lot more massive though, at 4.8 masses of Earth, and the Earth similarity for this planet is the stunning 76.6%. So far, pretty high. Now, in the previous video, I mentioned that we think that none of these do have such a high Earth similarity, but in this game, it actually uses a lot of factors, including the position around the star system, the actual mass, the amount of water on it, and so on and so forth, and also the atmosphere. None of these have atmospheres, but if they did, it would probably be even higher. Alright, let's go to the next object. So far, Proxima Centauri is definitely winning. And the next on the list is right here, Wolf 1061. And the planet we're looking for in the system is the planet C. There it is. Now, in this case, it is, for some unknown reason, a reddish-greenish planet. Very unusual look, but once again, the mass here is very high, and so the Earth similarity will be slightly lower at 53.2. This is somewhere between Mars and Venus in our solar system. And the interesting thing about this particular planet, as I mentioned in the last video, is that it's also probably very cold, and it orbits, once again, a red dwarf. So chances for atmosphere and water are very, very slim. The next is Gliese 832, and this was actually one of the last objects I mentioned in that last video. And if you look at this particular planet, in this simulation, it's actually what would be known as a mini Neptune. In other words, it's a kind of a gas giant, but not really a giant. It's a gas dwarf in a sense. And so because it's listed as a mini Neptune, its actual Earth similarity has fallen to below 50%. So this is not as exciting as Proxima Centauri, for example. Next on this list is Gliese 682. And here, the planet we're looking for is planet C. And planet C, if we actually look at it, is actually, once again, a kind of a mini Neptune, with the Earth similarity of 35.5%. So we're actually kind of going down now, even though I assume that this particular system is going to have a lot of planets that will have higher Earth similarity. Let's go to Gliese 667, and specifically Gliese 667C. Now here, we think that this one here, which already seems to be displayed as a water world, might have a slightly higher Earth similarity, 76.8. The scientists listed as 81, so might be even higher than that. And we think that this is actually probably the most Earth-like planet we've discovered so far. But we also think that maybe, just maybe, F, which has an Earth similarity of 81 and is also water world, and E have a high Earth similarity as well, here at 76.2. And these two, we don't really know exactly if they exist yet because they haven't been confirmed, but this one here, known as C, is confirmed, and we think that it's probably a very Earth-like world. We don't know if it's a water world, as you see here, but it's definitely an interesting world to explore with a very, very high Earth similarity. Now, the other stars are relatively far away, and one of the ones to explore here is also known as GJ 180, and this particular star has two objects that are somewhat in the habitable zone, but are actually a little bit too close to the star, so chances are they are not going to have very high Earth similarity, 35.4 here and 44.8. But there is one object I wanted to actually look at that is not in the, on this list. There is an object known as TRAPPIST-1, and you probably have heard about it before. And in TRAPPIST-1, we've discovered 7 terrestrial planets. Now, this is also a red dwarf, but there's a very, very high chance that at least a few of these will have a somewhat higher Earth similarity than Proxima Centauri. So we're looking to beat 95%. Let's go through these one by one and find out. All right, the first one has 77.6, already really high. The second one, 87. The third one, 91.8. You can see there's some water on the surface there. Next we have 85.5. 77.5 and 60.3, and we missed one, 72.9. So it seems like 91.8 is the highest Earth similarity we've achieved outside of Proxima Centauri. So interestingly, it's actually Proxima Centauri that, at least in this particular simulation, gives us the highest Earth similarity index. But scientists today think that this system will probably have the highest chance of finding a planet that does have liquid water and potential habitability on it, because, you know, there's 7 of them, so chances here are much higher. Nevertheless, it's very likely that it's probably the Proxima Centauri system with its Proxima Centauri planet, Proxima b, that we're going to be exploring first and discovering what mysteries it actually hides. Now, to be honest here, every time you create a new system, the game does change the parameters just slightly, so for the most part, the Earth similarity will also change. So if I look at it again right now, you'll see that it's actually going to 94, 95, 96, 96, 95. And if I open a simulation that's already pre-made in this game, known as Proxima b, in this simulation, the Proxima b planet will look a little bit different, and we'll also have a slightly different Earth similarity as well, at 87%. So these are kind of not persistent throughout simulations, mostly because of the composition, albedo effect, and so on, that is present on the planet and changes depending on when you start the simulation. Anyway, hopefully you enjoyed this video, and hopefully now you know about the exoplanets and their Earth similarity index, and hopefully now you know that it is actually Proxima b and the TRAPPIST planets that are the most exciting objects we know of that have the highest Earth similarity to our own planet Earth, even higher than Venus, even higher than Mars and any other planet except for, of course, Earth. In some of the future videos, we might explore these objects in more detail, and we might even find an exoplanet somewhere on that list that you see right here that is not discussed in this video, and that might even have something higher than Proxima Centauri. Maybe one day we'll discover that planet, and maybe it will be actually a planet inside TRAPPIST-1 or some other system that we know of but are not aware of the planet in it. Future will tell. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and hopefully you learned something from it. And if you did, don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to share this video with someone who enjoys watching space videos. And come back tomorrow to learn something else. Let's finish this video with a beautiful bang by basically explode the system. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Space out. And as always, bye-bye.